Good day and welcome to Mission Control Houston. Today is Friday, September 6, 2013, and this is Space Station Live. On board the International Space Station, a crew of six people continues to work in support of research aboard the orbiting outpost. Commander Pavel Vinogradov and flight engineers Alexander Mazurkin, Chris Cassidy, Fyodor Yurchikhin, Luca Parmitano, and Karen Nyberg are orbiting the planet at an altitude of about 250 statute miles, currently over the southern Indian Ocean. Supporting the crew on the ground here in Mission Control Houston are Flight Director Holly Ridings and Spacecraft Communicator Capcom Hal Getzelman, working with the crew on all the different activities scheduled for today. This is another busy week aboard the International Space Station. It's getting ready to near an end, and the crew's looking forward to a full weekend this weekend. The highlight of this week was Wednesday's undocking and departure of the HTV-4 or H-2 Transfer Vehicle 4, the Japanese cargo vehicle that delivered several tons of cargo to the space station and is now carrying trash and refuse that will be destroyed after it is commanded to begin a fiery reentry through the Earth's atmosphere early tomorrow morning. The Japanese HTV-4 cargo ship continues now to phase away from the space station after its departure and release by flight engineer Karen Nyberg, and is scheduled to fire its engines for a destructive deorbit at 1:36 a.m. Central Time Saturday. The Wednesday activity involved reaching out and grappling HTV-4 as it was berthed to its common berthing mechanism port on the station, moving it away to the full length of Canada Arm 2. That was performed by the ground, and then Karen Nyberg released the vehicle. It was then commanded by the Mission Control Center in Tsukuba, Japan to make thruster firings that led it to a stately departure from the International Space Station. NASA and the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency are working together to gather extensive data and imagery of the reentry with data gathering devices on the spacecraft. Some of that will include imagery gathered by the crew and the iServe science camera, which is usually applied to photographing natural disasters on the Earth. The HTV-4 reentry observation is a test to define the photographic exposure and pointing limits that ultimately determine how high and how precisely we can locate a reentering spacecraft. There are certain areas of the reentry environment for spacecraft that we don't know a lot about. Crew will be shooting a wide range of different exposures on three different cameras from the space station's cupola, which is a 360-degree bay window connected to the Tranquility module. They'll be trying to capture the faint plasma trail of HTV-4 as it breaks up in the lower atmosphere. Mission Control has been working to determine exactly where the crew will need to look, as the HTV will be taking up less than a pixel in the entire field of view in those pictures. This week, the crew worked on a variety of different experiments, including more work with the Sphere satellites in the Japanese Kibo laboratory. Spheres satellites, small bowling ball-sized self-contained satellites, are designed to interact with one another and maintain relative positions. This particular set of experiments used a smartphone technology to send commands to the free-flying orbs. They also work with the ACE-1 experiment, which looks at very small micron-sized particles that are suspended within liquids called colloids. The experiment looks at strands of such particles to try to develop ideal mixtures, to develop products that will help improve the quality of life for everyday people, detergents, shampoos, fabric conditioners, and the like. They also work with a human reaction experiment this week, some fluids experiments, combustion experiments, and today are taking spinal ultrasound imagery of Karen Nyberg. There was also maintenance aboard the space station this week. Chris Cassidy replaced an air valve in the carbon dioxide removal system that is in the Tranquility module of the station. That occurred on Thursday, and that'll help keep the atmosphere of the crew breathes at the proper balance without a lot of extra effort from Mission Control. Mission Control has been having to do some extra work to unstick the old valve periodically, and this replacement should help return it to more automated operations. Meanwhile, the crew of six worked together to train and prepare for the upcoming departure of Commander Pavel Vinogradov, Flight Engineer Chris Cassidy, and Flight Engineer Alexander Masurkin. They are loading items and performing final training for the departure of the Soyuz TMA-08M spacecraft that is scheduled to undock and land on the steppe of Kazakhstan next Tuesday. There will be a change of command ceremony that takes place on Monday, September the 9th, in which Vinogradov will hand off command to his colleague Fyodor Yurchikhin of the Expedition 36-37 crew. And then we will have a hatch closing scheduled for 3:20 p.m. Central Time on Tuesday. Undocking will be scheduled for 6:37 p.m. Central Time. And then that trio is scheduled to land on the steppe of Kazakhstan at 9:59 p.m. Central Time Tuesday. Meanwhile, in Russia, the Expedition 37-38 Prime crew, Mike Hopkins, Oleg Kotov, and Sergei Ryzhansky, who will be replacing Vinogradov, Masurkin, and Cassidy aboard the space station. They are conducting their final round of Soyuz vehicle qualification exams this week at the Gagarin Cosmonaut Training Center in Star City, Russia, and will begin preparations for their launch to the International Space Station, which is scheduled for Wednesday, September 25, Houston time, Thursday, September 26 in Kazakhstan. We're also getting ready for the launch and arrival of yet another cargo vehicle. The Orbital Sciences Cygnus vehicle will be launching from the Wallops Flight Facility in Virginia and heading for the International Space Station on September the 17th with a rendezvous and grapple planned for Sunday, September 22. That launch is scheduled for 10:16 a.m. Central Time on September 17, and we'll expect rendezvous and berthing at 8:05 a.m. Central Time on Sunday, September 22. All in all, a very busy week for the crew aboard the International Space Station as we get ready for the departure of half of that crew. We will be following along as the crew enjoys a two-day weekend on Saturday and Sunday, and then back with coverage of the International Space Station Monday morning. Again, this is Mission Control Houston.